an award-winning author of 6 collections of poetry that include Profane Halo, Lovers in the Used World, and Tall Strangers, a finalist for the National Book Critics Circle Award. And her work has received many printing prizes, including the Jerome Shestack Poetry Prize, the Fun for Poetry Award, and a National Endowment for the Arts Grant.
Wow.
Her work has also been anthologized in over 20 national and international anthologies, including W.W. Norton's American Hybrid, Counterpath's Postmodern Lyricism. And Gillian is also the editor and founder of Volt Magazine. She teaches in the program for writers and poets at Sonoma State University and is currently translating Henri Michaud's 400 Men on the Cross. Can't wait to see that. So, happy to be celebrating a fantastic book of poetry, The Plot Genie, and really delighted to have her with us.
Great to read with Craig. Are you taking a video, Craig? Are we going to be on YouTube tomorrow? Let's not be on YouTube. Take them. No, it's great to read with Craig. And it's terrific to be here with Don. Thank you very much, Rusty Morrison and Ken Keegan. And thank you, Peter Marvals, who always makes everyone sound so amazing. Mm-hmm. And you can hear me in the back.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. There's a breeze coming. Do you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, slightly.
I'm going to do kind of the opposite of what Craig did. I'm going to read from a little bit from The Plot Genie, and then I'm going to read some new work, because I know there's some people here who heard The Plot Genie many times. And for those of you who haven't, the book takes its title from a plot-generating device that was created by an ex-silent screenwriter and who also had an interest in numerology and horse racing, and Wycliffe A. Hill. Little numbers guy. And he wrote it. It took him 16 years to come up with this sort of insane system that he had. I didn't use the book as a chance operation, but instead the system suggested the book that I wrote. I'm getting reverb. Do you? Is that okay? It's okay? All right. Okay. So, I'll read the first poem, The Plot Genie. Oh, one thing that's really cool is there's a rear window effect up here.
Yes.
If a person is fawning or obsequious to another, to remove a taboo, to be rid of carping, the desire to obtain possession of a key, insanely jealous love, we are here to escape payment of a lost wager, to secure life insurance, to escape an abomination. Evening, white sand, a small distant figure, tiny sultan, or a speck on the windshield stirring, a natural reality of white summer of white panes. Once a handsome dead man was floating on the pool, white sand, small distant figure came into view, and you felt a pang of delight under your skull as we drove on, speck on the windshield stirring in white summer of white panes. Then home to read night's starry dismemberment of book, Hamlet's toque feather drifting down Mallarmé's page. And come morning, we were going up to Portland, backing out the car. It was day. A moose was sighted in the forest. A bus decayed in its interior. The palace gate swung shut. Low, evaporating trails of night terror of what happening, the getting there of next. Let me introduce Miss Jane Sloan, head of the department, and a very capable authoress, dozing off in an armchair near the window, near nature producing its unidentical designs, the chasm side of a stick of butter. The plot genie is baking a pan of biscuits. The plot genie is one of the most virile helps which has ever been devised. Someone is falling into an ancient cave comfort, barely touching another origin, dialing a unique number and none other, holding the plot genie in the hollow of an arm while careful not to bend, spinning while out the palace gates trots a horse, color of gray, dark splotch. Soon we are approaching the studios to say, was it better than a painting? To get even with someone? To use a colloquialism? In the light of a game or a sporting event? In the house of shadows, the shadow of the house. In the house, I hear nothing but laughter, weaponry, airy plumes on helmets, war relics, and attic wasps. In the dusty corners, parasitical words having drunk of an antiquity by whose forces Europe ruled. The house resting blankly in wintry afternoon, curing in the sun like a little ham. The plot genie's hand reflected in the lake, her hand smudged in the flat, calm glare. In a bunkhouse, underworld dope den, back of a music hall, in a bachelor's apartment. Betty, then Veronica, meticulously dressed in the margins, Archie never drawn too quickly, but with patience, exactitude, and the white rapids he might one day shave from his face, always speaking in the simple human tongues that Sappho kept going, admiring their clarity. To be free, and 21, to be born into a lush landscape and to come back to it in a box, as if in an old evening suit. The genie tells you what happens and you listen, as if in repay for the years the swarming locust has eaten. The genie tells you what happens, and then along come still others to explain. If you still don't get it, the plot genie repeats.